Tonight, by order of the court, at 11:45 p.m. Central Standard Time, the state of Alabama carried out the execution of Thomas Douglas Arthur by lethal injection at the Holman Correctional Facility in Atmore, Alabama. Thomas Arthur was executed for the 1982 capital murder of Troy Wicker. Before his execution, the inmate made the following statement. Mr. Arthur said goodbye to his children and said, "I'm sorry I failed you as a father. I love you more than anything on earth." He was pronounced deceased by a physician at 12:15 p.m. Excuse me, that would be 12:15 a.m. At this time, I'll take questions.
What time did the execution actually begin?
The execution after the warrant was read by my clock at 11:50. It went exactly according to our protocol, yes.
Commissioner, this execution wasn't complete until after midnight. We don't have discussions on whether you had to complete it before midnight or if you started drugs prior.
Right. According to the protocol, the execution begins, and once the execution begins, as long as that's within the period of the death warrant, then we continue and complete the execution. I'm sorry?
Corey Wicker's family, did you get a chance to talk with them since
the not since. I spoke with them briefly this afternoon. They chose not to make a statement, and we have not heard from them since.
Can you talk about it taking 8 tries to actually get this execution to happen?
Yeah, the Department of Corrections, we're here just to carry out the lawful orders of the court, and so I would leave those discussions for others to discuss. Yes, that's correct.
Did can you walk us through the execution? Did he start to breathe heavily when the drug was administered?
As I said, this execution went exactly as our protocol describes it, and so to the extent that any of these types of things go according to schedule, if you were, this one went exactly according as described in our protocol.
Was Mr. Arthur allowed to have a picture of his family?
I know there was some discussion on that, and yes, we did allow Mr. Arthur to have a picture of his family in the chamber with him. The chaplain had that on his person during the entire time.
I know they mentioned earlier he didn't make any special requests. Did he later on through the evening make any special food or meal or any other type of requests?
Not that I'm aware of, no.
What was the, you think, is the main difference between what you witnessed and everybody else witnessed in December's execution versus what happened?
Which execution?
Ronald Wordsmith.
Right, yeah, at that one, as we've said, I did observe that Ronald Wordsmith had heavy breathing and he coughed a few times. In this case, Mr. Arthur was conscious and talking to the chaplain, and then it was as if he went to sleep.
Go back and explain a little bit about the execution had to be underway by midnight. Is that under the law? That's okay.
When we consulted with the Attorney General's office, that was their guidance to us, that as long as we had begun the execution within the period of the death warrant, then we should continue and complete the execution.
Commissioner Dunn, I've got people asking on Facebook, could you explain the procedure for execution?
Well, that's a classified within, that's a confidential protocol within the department, so we don't normally go into the details other than what I've just shared.
Can you tell us what drugs were used?
Again, that's a part of our protocol,
yes,
and so we wouldn't share that for the